West Virginia with their lowest scoring half since only putting up 18 in their opener against Gonzaga. West Virginia also with losses this year to Davidson, Oklahoma in Orlando, and then Oklahoma again in their Big 12 opener. Lost to Duquesne and Michigan as well. So the Mountaineers at 7-6, the Longhorns at 8-6 after both dropping their Big 12 openers. This is a big game for both of these teams early in conference play. And there's a three that goes down for Jonathan Holmes.
Some manhood checking going on in the halftime break by both coaches. Texas came out the first possession defensively and with double teaming the basketball, really forced West Virginia to a quick shot.
Eric Murray threw a double team. It'll stay with West Virginia as this is now Texas's largest lead at 6. Murray from the corner. He can shoot the three, but it looked as if maybe Holmes got a piece. Lewis gives it up to Felix. He hangs and hits. A terrific finish by Javon Felix.
He's coming up grimacing a little bit.
And now out of control, losing control is Jabari Hines. But they'll say it was deflected out by Texas. I don't know. It looked like Hines may have simply lost control of the basketball and it might have just floated out of bounds. It might have been a break for West Virginia. And now they'll change the call and give it back to the Horns.
Well, you don't see Jabari Hines upset at all. He understands that's the correct call. Just trying to make something happen for his team, getting a little frustrated here. First 5 minutes, always critical, especially for the road team, trying to establish themselves.
West Virginia has only one team assist at this point.
Eric Murray got away with a little foul there. You got to be careful.
Papa Petru can't hit, but then a foul is called on Jonathan Holmes for Texas.
Well, watch defender here. There's Kevin Doreen, and there's Jabari Hines right there. And now the defender, Eric Murray, comes out late on the closeout. Jonathan Holmes can hit that face-up jumper. That's a rare open opportunity for either team here tonight.
Another foul called against Texas. This will go against Cameron Ridley. First on Ridley. As we said, West Virginia averages a little over 13 assists per game, which is not a terrific total in and of itself. And they only have one assist so far tonight. And we're a minute and a half into the second half.
Well, this is when shooting becomes a premium, especially for these two teams. And surprise, Matthew Humphreys isn't off the bench for West Virginia.
Another foul called on Ridley. That's his second. In about 20 seconds. And that will put Jabari Hines at the free throw line.
Well, we talked about it in the open. West Virginia scores a higher percentage of their points from the free throw line than any other Power 6 team. This bodes well for West Virginia trying to close this gap on the road. Again, Bob, this is an easier place to come in and try to steal a victory. This Irwin Center is so comfortable. They got these individual padded seats and the fans rarely get up. They need some bleachers in here. West Virginia get with an outstanding opportunity here.
Jabari Hines makes a couple at the line. 2 minutes gone by now here in the second half. Another foul. No, check that, a kickball called. So it'll stay with Texas. Rick Barnes, a three-time Big 12 Coach of the Year. 13 consecutive 20-plus win seasons. And he's taken Texas to the tournament 14 years in a row.
That's consistency, but he's having his patience tested here this year. Mike Kabongo situation, having to rely on these young players. And they're talented, Bob, but they have to go through the fire to figure out how to win games. It seemed like they had that Baylor game at hand and let it slip away.
Terry Henderson able to hit the wide open look.
And Texas would like to run the basketball. They would like to get the ball off the floor. Understanding they struggle offensively as well, trying to create easy opportunities.
Nice play by Papa Petru, a touch pass to avoid the steal. Felix gets caught in midair, gives it up to eBay, and he'll go to the line. So it was nearly a steal by Jabari Hines, but Ioannis Papapetrou, the freshman from Greece, with a really nice heads-up play to keep it alive. He just missed it there on the touch pass.
Right here, Felice with the adjustment in midair to Prince eBay.
Eric Murray called for his third foul as well. So that's three fouls now on Murray, Kalichla, and Rutledge. Watch the heads-up play by Papapetrou there. Not only to avoid the steal, but also to get the one-touch pass off to Felice.
Papapetrou's got some instincts in his blood. Dad played professionally in Greece. His mom played soccer, so he has those instincts, and you can see it. Couples it with hard work. And it's upside for that young man here in Austin, Texas.
Back into the 2-3 zone, go for the Longhorns.
See Rutledge and Doreen back in.
A block by eBay and a takeaway by McClellan. He just about gave it up though. Felice on the deck, picks up the loose ball. And now numbers for the Longhorns. Felice gives it up. Lewis comes up short. A chance for a run out for West Virginia. Here comes Gary Brown. Spinning, and Felice just about took it away. Rutledge settles it down as the game has gotten a bit frantic, and now a foul call.
Oh, looks like they're going to get the sweat off the floor.
Check that. Yep, John Higgins with moisture on the floor, and Bob Huggins saying, you know, we were about to get maybe ball movement for an uncontested look on the baseline, and you stop the game for a wet spot.
Because not a lot of openings have been there for West Virginia. Struggling, shooting only 25% in the first half, but still within striking distance. And it's going to come down to three or four possessions, Bob. 50-50 balls, some fast break points, and some offensive rebounds. And so far, West Virginia has the advantage in those areas.
And a foul called under the basket on Prince eBay as Javon Felice is over on the Texas bench getting an all-too-rare rest as eBay picks up his third.
Well, Prince eBay, you see how long and thin he is, but can bench press 250. You had a bet with Coach Barnes, and Coach Barnes is like, I don't think you can do that. He went to the weight room, that fella pushed up 250. So, extremely athletic, but raw.
eBay back out, Ridley back on.
Nice closeout defensively by Texas. DeMarcus Hollins link really deteriorating the perimeter of West Virginia.
Shot clock down to 7. Hines gives it up to Brown. Shot clock at 4. Brown drives, hangs, and hits.
Bob, that warms my heart right there. Because a lot of times in college basketball, you'll see the shot clock run down, and you'll see a guard try to dance with the ball, create space, and shoot a contested 3. Brown, understanding what their strength is, got right to the back bucket.
Ridley, nice post move, but it's slapped away by Hines. It will stay with Texas when we come back. 31-27. The Longhorns have the lead. The first ever Big 12 road game for West Virginia, and they're down by 4. John Calipari brings in a bunch of players with Nerlens Noel, thought to be a one and done. You get off to the rocky start, unranked at this point. What's their bounce back potential?
I think they'll be competitive, but I think they're the third best team in the SEC, and it's just weird not to see any numbers next to Kentucky. You know, for them not being ranked. And I think that Florida and Missouri are the class of the SEC. And defensively, Kentucky's starting to improve. But in order to really make a dent in the SEC, they're going to have to sneak off some upsets. And I don't think they have the firepower to do it.
Hi, Stephen Bardo. I'm Bob Wischusen here in Austin. 10 on the shot clock for West Virginia. Still looking for their first made 3 of the game. And it's another turnover as Jabari Hines knees it out of bounds. And a frustrating night into the offensive end for Bob Huggins' group continues.
You know, Jabari Hines means well. You know, he wants to win. He wants to do the right thing. But he gets outside of his game, Bob, and you gotta stick within your game. If you're limited offensively, stick within your game. Let somebody else have the opportunity when the shot clock's running down.
Lewis, a floater from the elbow, and a smooth one at that for Julian Lewis.
Julian Lewis, on the other hand, is a man that knows his game, doesn't do things outside of what he's capable of doing, so he always looks like he's under control. Oh, Brown's got to be ready to shoot that.
Hines will try instead. That's no good. 0-for-13 from three for West Virginia.
Kevin Durant set Brown up beautifully with a shot fake, put it on the deck, drew the defense. He kicked out to Gary Brown, but he wasn't ready to shoot it. West Virginia is not going to get very many opportunities with Brown shooting three. Not very good from there, but he can do what Staten did early in the game, take a couple bounces inside. Just be ready to shoot.
Hines back on the bench now as Aaron Harris checks in. And a foul called against Texas. Reach-in called on Julian Lewis.
Look at the nice kick out by Kevin Durant. And look at that. He hesitates. He had Julian Lewis off balance, and it resulted in another missed shot. So Gary Brown's got to be ready to either shot fake and put it on the deck or let it fly. I know he's not very good from three, but you're not going to get very many opportunities like that against this staunch defense of the Longhorns.
That foul on Lewis, his third. So that takes him out of the game as Papa Petru comes back on. Rutledge in the post. Nice up and under, but hit the underside of the rim after he beat Ridley on the baseline. Felix gets it to Papa Petru, but it's taken back by Rutledge. And then an over and back. He stepped on the midcourt line.
Remember the old Excedrin PM commercials? Take a look if Rutledge steps out of bounds.
He's got the ball, and then his heel stepped on the midcourt line.
Got to be more aware than that. Again, we're talking about a senior, Bob. That's a freshman mistake right there. Rutledge has got to be more aware than that.
Long, tough entry, but a foul called, and that will most likely go against Rutledge. It will. That's his third. That's actually his fourth, pardon me. So Rutledge now has four. That'll get Kalichla with three fouls up off the West Virginia bench. Arik Murray has three. So as we said, and this, you could see this building at the start of the game, Steve.
Yeah.
The front court fouls came early and often for West Virginia, that Bob Huggins was going to have to massage this game through the second half to keep his best front court players on the floor. And now Kalichla inside fighting for position with Cameron Ridley. He nearly picked up a foul. Papa Petru on the drive comes up short.
I like that opportunity, though. Papa Petru going to the rim. Had a little sliver of daylight. Didn't get it to fall, but I'm sure Rick Barnes is okay with that. Cameron Ridley in the center now for Texas. Doing a good job of communicating with his teammates.
Kalichla, the jump hook, and a beauty at that. That's his go-to shot, as Kalichla, with that hook shot, makes it a four-point game.
Dennis Kalichla, along with Khalif Wyatt of Temple, and other players have been on the all-old-school game. And I'm surprised that more players don't use that jump hook because it's unstoppable. You can't block it.
Holmes drives, finishes, plus the foul.
That's the second time we've seen that this evening, Bob. Jonathan Holmes setting up this move with the good ability to shoot the three, puts it on the deck. Big fella, shows some dexterity.
It's like the preeminent conference in college basketball.
Yeah, definitely this season when you see the six-ranked teams right there. It's unfortunate that Josh Gosser of Wisconsin is out for the season with an ACL tear, or Wisconsin would be right there with the way that Bo Ryan is able to develop the consistency in Madison.
offensive play between these two teams tonight has been anything but consistent, as both coaches trying to find some answers in what's been a low-scoring defensive battle. Six-point lead for Texas. Shot clock down to 10. McClellan's step-back jumper comes up way short. Ridley keeps it alive on the offensive glass. Taken away by Noreen, and then a foul called on Ridley. Team foul number 6 called on Texas here in the second half, and the third on Cameron Ridley, all in the second half.
Sheldon McClellan, lead scorer for the Longhorns, is a shell of himself. He has no explosion of pop on his jumper. He usually, with that 6'4 frame, is able to elevate easily over his defenders. He just doesn't have it tonight. Trying to gut it out.
He had the ankle injury in the first half, and watching how his ankle, maybe even arguably a high ankle sprain, got rolled up on in the first half, it's pretty impressive he's even on the floor.
Well, Rick Barnes, one of those old school coaches, Bob. He's going to test your manhood.
Put some Windex on it.
That's right.
Get back out there.
Put some Robitussin on.
Ten to shoot for West Virginia. Gary Brown comes up way short in the lane. Kalichla, he's blocked inside by Prince Ibeck.
So McClellan right there, if he's healthy, he lets that fly. Prince Ibeck trying to show his presence in the paint area. One of the reasons why this team is so good defensively.
Felix got Noreen caught on a switch. Papapetru instead on the drive, and a blocking foul is going to go against Gary Brown. That'll be team foul number 4 on West Virginia. So it's free throws the rest of the way for the Mountaineers. As we said, 16 fouls against Texas. And we talked about it in our open as Noreen and Brown both go to the West Virginia bench, Steve. The Mountaineers live at the line.
Yes.
And they're going to shoot free throws the rest of the way. It could be a big key in this game.
They have to, because they can't score consistently any other way. They've got to put pressure on the defense. They've got to drive to the bucket. They need to get the ball inside.
McClellan is fouled. And Kalichla goes down hard. Eric Murray called for the personal. That's his fourth. So now Murray has 4. Dominique Rutledge on the bench with 4. That gets Kevin Noreen back up and right back in the game. And the foul trouble in the front court continues to pile up for the Mountaineers.
Well, Bob Huggins doesn't like going zone. Pretty much doesn't have any options but to slide back to a 2-3 just to try to make it through the game.
Kevin Noreen only has 1 foul, so at least that's a big body that he can most likely count on the rest of the way. As McClellan hits a pair at the line, which is news in and of itself tonight for Texas, as they are now at 39% from the free throw line as a team, 7-18 in the game. Good hands by Felix to create the turnover.
Javon, once again, showing his maturity in his game. Having to play so many minutes. Starting to really pick up the defensive principles Rick Barnes wants him to have.
Kalichla knocks away the attempt by Felix. Harris at midcourt. Swoops in. Can't finish.
Nice job of Sheldon McClellan. Challenging the shot without foul.
Papapetru goes down hard. The follow on the weak side by eBay. And Papapetru is hurt. Kalichla slid underneath Papapetru, and he's there to check and see if Papapetru is okay. A no call by the officials, and Papapetru hit the deck hard. Landed on his right hip.
I still like the no call here. You know, incidental contact. Fell on his lower back. You see Kalichla was just really trying to get out of the way. Just unfortunate. Papapetru.
It is a war of attrition tonight between these two teams. Foul trouble, injuries. We saw Dennis Kalichla go to the bench in the first half with what looked like a boxer's cut over his right eye. Papapetru now on the bench as he lands on his right hip. Sheldon McClellan with what looked like a pretty good ankle sprain in the first half, but inside of about 3 minutes, he was back in the game. Kalichla catches it deep, can't finish with the left hand, and here comes McClellan.
Well, Kalichla got away with an offensive foul there. hit eBay right in the stomach with an elbow, but kept his hand on the ball. Try to create the space.
A three from the corner comes up short for Lewis. Hines has it stripped away. Tried to get it back and turns it over. Good hands by Sheldon McClellan again. Let's take a look at what has been an ugly night, to say the least. Only 23 total points scored here in the second half, and field goal percentages for both teams well below 40%.
You know, Bob, and I see teams struggle, but some of these shots have no chance.
Here's a chance for a three-point play. Connor Lambert able to draw the foul on Kalichla. That's his fourth.
At some point, the front line of West Virginia has to adjust to the way the game is being called. This crew has been fairly consistent this evening in terms of how they're calling it in the paint, Bob, but the bigs of West Virginia have not adjusted.
And it's a 13-point lead as Kalichla stays in the game. He has four. Eric Murray and Dominique Rutledge both on the bench with four. Kalichla, the deep jump hook, and he draws the foul. We've had a lot of fouls called. Obviously, Bob Huggins has foul trouble to worry about, but as you said, Steve, I don't think we have seen any fouls tonight. I can't think of one where after the foul was called by a member of the officiating crew, it seemed even questionable.
Right.
I mean, for the most part, I think the fouls have been there, and they've called the fouls that were there. It's just that kind of game.
It is. Two rugged defensive teams that struggle on the offensive end, so they have to grind everything out, and that's exactly what we've got. It's just a grind-out war of attrition. Both teams.
And Kalichla misses a pair. Coming up on 4 minutes with no points for West Virginia. And they have fallen behind by 13. Another loose ball in the lane. It's a held ball, and it'll stay with the Longhorns.
Pretty good post feed that time. Felice. Lambert the ball in scoring position. He had a mismatch with Jabari Hines trying to guard him, giving up about 6 or 7 inches.
Quick trigger by McClellan. In and out. It could be Kevin Noreen and a bunch of guards by the time the game ends for West Virginia. Knifing through and finishing is Jabari Hines. A much needed field goal for the Mountaineers.
Jabari Hines just put his head down that time and would not be denied. Defensive transition for Texas was poor on that possession. West Virginia takes advantage. Right now, Lambert and Prince Ibe both a little challenged the post.
Shot clock at 5. Lambert may not realize it, now does. Tough fadeaway. It's an air ball and a shot clock violation. And appropriately, that takes us to break. An 11-point lead for Texas here in the state capitol. 7:22 to go in Austin. With 7.5 remaining.
Well, with the foul trouble up front, I would expect West Virginia to try to free Terry Henderson at some point, their best perimeter shooter. Tech's doing a good job of shading him with Sheldon McClellan.
Kalichla in the post, goes to the left-handed hook again and scores. And the lead is down to 9.
He could get that every time, Bob. If they take their time and get him on that left block, Cameron Ridley cannot stop that shot.
Leaks a little stutter step floater that won't go. Offensive rebound for Jonathan Holmes. He loses it, and it's picked up by Terry Henderson. Henderson with a pull-up. No good. Traveling call as Ridley was undercut by Kevin Noreen. And the crowd not in love with Terry Oglesby decision.
This allows we've heard the crowd all night. Right here. Cameron Ridley establishing his position. Just gets his feet caught up.
Looked like a good no call.
Yep.
So we have a timeout on the floor, and we'll step aside as well for just a moment. 6.5 minutes to go here in Austin. As we're down inside of 6.5 minutes to play. And both teams will shoot free throws the rest of the way as both are over the limit. Where does West Virginia go now for their offense?
Dennis Kalichla has found some success on that left block. But I would go away from Terry Henderson. Try to find him as well. He's the one guy who can stretch the defense a little bit.
There's Kalichla. Felix called for the foul. That will put Kalichla back at the free throw line. First foul on Javon Felix.
Javon did everything right except for foul. You want to dig in on Kalichla. You don't want to double team. You just want to dig and provide support. He did that. He's got a little overzealous.
And Kalichla makes the front end. West Virginia has made at least one three in 436 consecutive games. They are 0 for 13 tonight. And that's a big reason why they find themselves down, but still within striking range by only 7 with 6 minutes to go.
There's no question about it. And now they found Kalichla the last few times, so they're starting to develop a rhythm. They can get some stops. It's going to get interesting here.
Lewis from 15 is able to connect again.
Simple pin down screen. Jonathan Holmes freed up Julian Lewis for the curl shot. It's a very simple play, but good job by the Longhorns getting a much needed bucket.
9 points now for Lewis. 5.5 minutes to go. Kalichla fights for post position again. Finds Hines, three on the way. It's an air ball. 0 for 14 from three for West Virginia.
Well, Hines has no confidence from the three-point line. He just shot that because he was open. Again, once that state, rather, showed the way early in the game. One three-point opportunity and took two dribbles and got inside to his ring.
We have not seen him in quite some time. Ridley muscles it up. And a blocking foul call that'll put Cameron Ridley at the free throw line. Kevin Nareen called for his second. So Cameron Ridley, a McDonald's All-American, in double figures a couple of times so far this season.
They utilize that quite a bit.
Especially this time of year.
Yep.
One of two for Ridley. Texas now 10 of 21 at the free throw line. So if the Longhorns had even had a decent night at the line, this would be a pretty commanding lead. As it is now, it's 10 with 4:42 to go.
Well, they're doing just enough to keep a comfortable cushion.
Kalichla flips a wild one up. That won't go, but a foul called on Ridley. That'll be his fourth.
Jonathan Holmes trying to instruct Cameron Ridley to go straight up. I'm sure the big fella thought that's exactly what he did on the defensive end. But Cameron Ridley, a big man, a few words. Let's throw it.
So Prince Ibe comes back on as Ridley with four fouls goes to the bench. Here on ESPN2, as soon as we are done here in Austin, we'll head to Berkeley as Washington will take on Cal. Long range jumper hits the side of the backboard for Sheldon McClellan. Jabari Hines gives it up. And now it's Kalichla again across the lane. Swoops to his right. That doesn't go. Nareen, an offensive rebound and a reset. Losing it, as it looked as if Terry Henderson was about to try a three, gave it away to Felix.
Like they were going to go back to Kalichla, on the post. West Virginia, good discipline, trying to get the big fellow to carry them home.
Lewis at the free throw line, in and out. Offensive rebound and a putback by Jonathan Holmes.
Wow, Jonathan Holmes looked like he got away with a push. Kept Peters in the first row.
Another scramble for a loose ball. It's Gary Brown.
Looks like Jonathan Holmes is hurt.
Noreen for three. That's good. The first three of the night for West Virginia goes down with 3 minutes and 10 seconds to go. And this is still very much a game in doubt. 7-point lead for Texas.
Guys really trying to pressure Felix. Just want to keep him in front.
Line drive jumper off the mark by Lewis, but Ibe an offensive rebound.
And he traveled.
And then takes steps. 11 turnovers for Texas. West Virginia was 0 for 14 from 3. Before, Kevin Noreen from the corner. A big shot for the Mountaineers keeps them in it. Stretch Texas will try and hold off the Mountaineers. 47-40, the Longhorns have the lead. Points have been hard to come by for both teams. Eric Murray back in the game for the first time in quite some time, playing with four fouls. Banks at home, and it's a 5-point lead for Texas.
West Virginia can lock down, Bob. Get a couple stops here on the road. They have found the secret to locking their offensive flow against this Longhorn defense. Cross screen in the paint.
Murray fights for the loose ball. It's saved but thrown to nowhere by Jonathan Holmes. So it goes back over to West Virginia, down by only 5.
Great reaction. Eric Murray slaps that ball away. If he does it, Holmes has an easy layup. So West Virginia trying to flex their muscles here late.
Crowd in Austin getting antsy. A 13-point lead at 1 point for Texas, down to 5. 2 minutes to go.
Oh, yeah, wide open.
Hines for 3. Got it! That's been a long time coming for Jabari Hines, and it's a 2-point game.
I give the young man some credit. Stepped up with some confidence.
The first player in double figures tonight for West Virginia. A steal by Gary Brown. Freezes in, plus the foul. A chance for West Virginia to take the lead.
Well, Bob Huggins' team, they look dead in the water, Bob. They made 3 key plays here on the defensive end. Shooting the gap, Gary Brown goes to the hole. And McClellan, you got to either let him go or you can't let him get it up over his shoulder. Just the worst position defensively to be in. And Gary Brown has an opportunity here.
Our first tie score of the night. And a timeout called with 1:26 to go. Sheldon McClellan called for his first. Virginia the lead. Can't do it. Brown hustles after his own miss, and it'll go to Texas.
That's the wrong call. That is the wrong call. That was not out on Gary Brown. Texas got a whole court break right there. Watch this. Right there. Jonathan Holmes is last to hit that.
It nicked the hand of Jonathan Holmes. So a break for Texas in a tie game.
West Virginia going to 1-3-1 zone. We haven't seen this all evening. Throwing Texas a wrinkle. Barnes probably needs to call timeout here.
McClellan a long way from the basket with 15 to shoot. And now a timeout is called by Rick.
Against what Rick Barnes is trying to do is a set play.
McClellan with 10 shoot, gives it up to Felix. Down to 8 on the shot clock. Felix, a long way from the basket, 5 to shoot. On the drive, it's Lewis. He comes up short, tapped around. Shot clock violation. 49 seconds to go, and it goes back over to West Virginia. Rick Barnes thinks it hit the rim. Maybe it grazed the rim on the carom, but the officials say no.
Aaron Harris, the freshman from Indianapolis, did a fantastic job of denying Felix the basketball and not allowing Texas to get into their offense.
Let's take a look on the shot. Obviously, that did not hit the rim as it caroms around. That's the right call by the officials on the shot clock violation. So now Bob Huggins wants a timeout with 44 seconds. Here we go.
We're going to see much of the same. A press reaction between Murray and Klitschler. Good job defensively of Texas and adjusting.
Shot clock at 15. Aaron Harris, the freshman, gives it up to Jabari Hines, the sophomore. Shot clock down to 9. Hines gets the high screen. Off to Brown. Ball movement to the freshman in the corner. And he hits it. Aaron Harris buries one from deep. Here comes Felix. Will Rick Barnes let his team go? Down by 3. Felix drives, can't score. Losing his balance is Ridley. And the officials grant Rick Barnes the timeout with 5.9 seconds to go.
Great ball movement as the shot clock is running down. West Virginia whipping the ball around the horn, finding Aaron Harris, who has come off the bench, Bob, and been superb late in this game.
Aaron Harris, a freshman from Indianapolis. Terry Henderson, a freshman from Raleigh. And earlier today, Bob Huggins told us those are our two best shooters, the two freshmen. And Aaron Harris gets a chance to prove it. In the
Wolves slipping out for a three-point shot.
Where does Texas go on a night where they've been ice cold from three? 5.9 seconds to go. Papa Petru will throw it in. From the corner, it's Holmes. Got it! 3 seconds to go. Into the front court goes Brown. Doesn't get it off. We're going to overtime. All night long, two teams that couldn't struggle more from the field are knocking down threes to force extra basketball. Hard to believe.
I'm at a loss for words right here. Jonathan Holmes sets the screen, and Rutledge hesitated, Bob. And Jonathan Holmes, he hit a shot. He hit a similar three earlier in the game from that very spot.
That quick a trigger from the corner. Maybe an unsuspecting three-point shooter if you're Bob Huggins. Again, it was a first guess by you. You did say, if you look at Kansas tonight, Iowa State has a chance to foul. They don't. McLemore hits the bank.